Hey guys, so this is the first ever like variety video I've posted since like having my YouTube channel and making a lot of game stuff, so I'm really nervous about it. I've always wanted to like do more variety in my channel, and I tend to do mostly Friday the 13th content, but I'm gonna start playing a little. I'm gonna get a new PC soon, so I'm gonna start playing some little PC games because I do most of my gaming on PlayStation because I'm a platinum trophy hunter, but I want to be able to take a break and step back and play a little more something that I don't have to strive for trophies. And I think PC gaming is good because Xbox has achievements. I do know Steam has achievements too, but I don't know, for some reason it's separate to me than others. But don't worry, I will still post my Friday the 13th content if that's what you're here for. But I wanted to throw this in too. I just, need a little break from time to time. So we're gonna start this, and this is Fingerbones. Okay, this is Fingerbones. This is a cycle intended to be completed in one sitting, and there's no save function. It is suggested that you set aside about a half an hour to an hour to complete it. All right. Let's go. Okay. Here we go. I am in a room. Okay. Yeah. It's my weekend to get Katie, but I'm really not in the mood. I distracted her with the TV and came here to read. I couldn't interest myself in reading, so I tried to write. I couldn't write anything more than the usual handful of disconnected thoughts and theories. Medication didn't help, and divorce certainly didn't help. Because I am not depressed, I am enlightened. This is the result of 2 decades of scientific education and philosophical pondering. This is the price of knowledge. Sure, okay. When I was 15, I lost my virginity. I shook uncontrollably the entire time. I felt that same primal excitement yesterday in the cellar. Okay. Sure. I see. Oh, yeah. Oh my God. Why can't I? It's so dark. It appears to be a page from a manuscript. Mortality is too reliant on emotions, and I'm not reliant enough on rational thought. If morally just to be determined, and I maintain that it is farce, it should not be determined by feeling. Feelings are nebulous, subjective, and changeable. Rather, it should be determined by thinking. The actions of a natural creature are natural and thus moral, unless a concrete scientific reason can be given to prove them as immoral. Gosh, it's dark. Flashlight! Much better. I can see now. Weird. Like, some stuff looks like you can grab it. Other times, no. No. Password. Password. Because it said Katie over here, didn't it? Katie, yeah. I assumed it would be the first name you read about. So that's the door I came in. Let's see if that opened the door. Yes. I'm winning. Winning. Nope, not winning that. I boxed up everything that isn't partial and useful. I burned all the books that weren't for scientific identification. I'd like to store the boxes in the cellar. Okay. But I can't get them down the ladder by myself. I just piled them up near the hatch and the blood would ruin them anyway. Okay. Why can't I read this? What's my problem? The tool room has been her name for years now. And I can't bring myself to change it. Katie? No. Must be a different password. It finally happened. The whole world is a chaos of thunder and screams. And when the ashes settle, we will be wild animals again. I am ecstatic beyond words, and I haven't been able to reach Lynn for several days, and she's probably dead for all I know or care. But Katie was here when it started, and I have no idea what to do with her. Most of the town is dead. Katie and I only survived because we ran to the bunker. Perhaps this is what I've needed. Freedom from all the irrational rules, insane social values, just pure, beautiful survival. Let's see if Lynn opens the next door. So, is this his daughter? And I guess Lynn was his wife or girlfriend. Yeah, it did something. Let's go. Quite a simple little game. I like this. Real simple. Minecraft graphics. Nope. Oh my god. That's blood. Yep. Yep, 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 yep. She remembered Father's Day and drew me a picture. I don't understand her. She's just like her mother. She wants to waste time drawing pictures, and we're barely able to find enough food to survive. I turned her crayons into candles. We need more candles in case the generator goes out again. It helps break up the monotony. I yearn for the excitement of those first weeks. What? He likes the excitement. He likes the excitement of craziness, I guess. The world ending, maybe. I changed the storage room code to something I can easily remember. NNY. The rest of the word is missing. NNY. That's Lynn backwards, right? Why am I moving so? Let's go see if that fixes the word. Or if that does the... opens the door. The door. If not, then I am wrong. NNYL. I think that opened the door. Nothing opens that door, though. I didn't see any other names. Okay. 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 I am a bag of DNA, and I exist to make more of myself. I married and produced a daughter because my genes demand reproduction. I wrote books and created their creativity served a survival advantage to my ancient ape ancestors. I built this place. This music is freaky. Took refuge in it and spent hours thinking up silly little artificial laws to live by because my forefathers built cities and societies to allow time and peace to reproduce and protect their genes, dreams, love, opinions, desires, beauty, innocence, figments of the collective primordial imagination, fleeting electronical signals that fire across our synthesis to a pointless moment in time. They used to serve a purpose, and now they are needless confusion, and here I am, the last man on Earth, for all I know, ready to be freed from them. Oh. Oh, gosh. The freak is that? What's this? What did that do? I thought that, like, that opened a door or something. Oh my god. Oh my. I thought maybe that would have opened a secret door somewhere. But I don't see anything. Oh, there's a paper here. There are things I've wanted to do for years, desires I've kept locked in the back of my consciousness. It's been nearly a year since I've seen a woman, and now I realize there's no practical reason to keep those desires locked up anymore. This is disturbing. Oh my god. Is he thinking... It's his daughter, isn't it? It's not a stepdaughter, right? Maybe if you knew his name, it would open the door. Time to Google it. Hold on a second. Okay, guys, so I had to cheat. I could not figure it out on my own, but it was freedom. I would have never figured that out. I would never. Thank gosh, Google tells you the answers. I don't know. I guess that my brain doesn't think like that. Okay, this should open the last door. Which is, I guess, the bunker. Even though I think we're already in a bunker, this is another bunker. And she's going to die anyway. I'm free now. Freedom. It took the end of all humanity for me to find freedom. Oh my. So I guess this game doesn't have any real jump scares. It's just the atmosphere is freaky. Oh my gosh. It seems I've been torn from a diary. She finally died last night. I don't know whether from starvation, dehydration, or blood loss. Okay. I threw her body into the woods, her fingers, my anti-religious artifacts, my testaments to moral and intellectual freedom are locked in the safe upstairs. I am content in the knowledge that I have done nothing wrong. Sure, if you are a murderer. What? The father didn't know why he came back to the cellar after all these years, starving and tired. He just wanted to see the cellar one last time. With one last flicker, the flashlight died, and he was left alone in the pitch dark. He sat down on the cold floor and closed his eyes. He could still hear her, even now. It was peaceful here in the cellar. It was free here in the cellar.
Okay, that was Fingerbones. Very interesting. More like a narrative story that was really creepy, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. And, yeah, thanks for watching.